Good morning. So today I'm going to take you all on a journey. And now some of you, or probably all of you, have been on this journey. And it's the journey into hospital. You might have been for personal reasons, you might have been with a loved one. We're quite lucky in the UK because we have the NHS. So if we're acutely unwell or there's an exacerbation of a chronic condition, for example, we can walk into a hospital and know that we're going to be looked after. What else can we expect? Care, quality, safety? Well, actually, you might be surprised to know that 7% of all admissions are actually due to adverse drug reactions, and 72% of those are avoidable. Let that just sink in for a second. 72% we can actually prevent. And one of the ways we can do this is via a process called medicines reconciliation. Now, some of you might already be familiar with that, and for those of you who aren't, medicines reconciliation is the process where we document a patient's medication from when they came into hospital. So this is anything they were taking before they came in. And it's important to know because it might be the cause of their admission. It might make them better, or it could potentially make them worse. So it's going to help with diagnosis and probably prognosis as well. So it is quite important. What my project is aiming to do is to help with the definition of medicines reconciliation, because what we find, or what we're finding, is the National Institute of Care and Excellence is saying we want this to be done within 24 hours of admission. So 24 hours of when a patient's admitted into hospital, we want them to receive medicines reconciliation. And that's not always happening, and that's unfortunate actually. And it might be due to the lack of understanding whose role and responsibility medicines reconciliation is. It might be our underpaid or overworked staff who are working night and day. And it might just be that we don't actually have a fully operational 7-day-a-week, 24 hours a day, NHS system. So considering all that, my project, like I said, will be helping to define medicines reconciliation, not just for staff, but for patients as well. We've already had interviews with patients and staff to try and develop an intervention. Once we get this intervention, we're going to roll that out into practice and, of course, test that as well. And I'm quite lucky, I'm not just doing the project with the university, I'm doing it with the hospital as well. So it very much will be translational research. We're going to have this end product and we're going to test it out in practice. It's not only going to reduce admissions, it's not only going to increase patient safety, but ladies and gentlemen, it will save lives. There's evidence to support that, and I'm standing here in front of you having done the research myself. Thank you very much for listening.